Hello there. No, you're not bothering me. Come on in. Take a sit down. Me? Oh, I'm just working on my list of honeydews that Laura gave me yesterday. Seems we have a few things to plan over the coming month. And if I don't put them in some sort of something formal, well, you know I'll likely just forget about them. Oh, heck no. Brownie, you should know better than that. Using email for these matters would be severely inadequate. I mean, well, I think if you say you're going to do something and don't do it, that's trustworthiness. And just so I command a high level of trustworthiness, I put my honeydews into a Microsoft project schedule. You know, one word sums up the responsibility of any president, and that one word is to be prepared. That's why I use Microsoft Project or Project on the Line, because if we don't succeed, we run the risk of failure. Come around here and take a look at my project schedule. Yes, Branny, it's clearly a schedule. It's got a lot of tasks in it. What I really like about it is that it's got this timeline feature. Also, let me show you how it works. I just finished this plan, so there's nothing showing in the timeline at the moment. What I like to do is put some of the key tasks in there so I can see when and when things are falling into place. For example, I want to make my task mail formal invitations visible, high and tight. So I'll first click on my timeline, which auto-detects the timeline tools format tab. Then, in the insert section of the ribbon, I click on the existing tasks. Pretty nifty how the pop-up shows me my tasks. It keeps them in the outline order. Sure helps me pick them. I'll select mail formal invitations. Then I'll select some summary tasks. Select and hire, ordering and delivery, barbecue prep, and setup. And I'll click OK. Now, these tasks are added to my timeline. But notice how my first ones leave a little to be desired from a visuality standpoint. Can't even tell what it is, right? Right. Let me click on it. Now, in the current selection section of the ribbon, click on Display as Callout. Presto mundo. Now we can see it. I'll do the same to the last one. Setup. Here's another little trick I like to teach you, Brownie. I'm going to add another timeline to my schedule display here and fill it with my milestones like this in the insert section of the ribbon. Click on the timeline bar. Next, I'll click on the new timeline that was just inserted. Then, click on the existing tasks button again, and in the pop-up box, I'll select me some milestones, okay? I'll select all of my milestones. There. I can see that they're hard to read on account of them being on top of one another. But I think you've misunderestimated my abilities with this tool. Look at this. I'm the decider on how these should look. You can grab the milestones on the timeline and move them where you want to make a more visual impaction. Excellent, Brownie. Now that's one heck of a schedule, wouldn't you say? And now I can use the email. I can send the timelines to Laura so she can stay instigated with the plan so we're both on the same page. Just right-click in the timeline area and choose Copy Timeline. Then select for the email. If I had an email open to Laura, I could cut and paste it there and send it. What else I got? Oh, here's one. Select a task from the top timeline and change the date format. Make it better. Use the date format picker in the Show Hide section of the Timeline Tools format tab. Here's another couple. With the pan and zoom checkbox selected, I can use the timeline to change my Gantt chart timescale. See? You can increase the thickness of the bar style items in your timeline by increasing the number of text lines, like this. Finally, and a really neat feature when you have a schedule that's packed with activities, you can quickly and easily navigate to the task in your schedule with right-click on a summary, a task, or a milestone in the timeline, and choosing Go to Schedule Task. That ought to wrap things up for you, Brownie. But remember, our scheduling challengers are innovative and resourceful, and so are we. They never stop thinking about new ways to harm our planning and our projects, and neither do we. There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's in Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me, well, you can't get fooled again. So when you find yourself in a bind and someone fooling in with you, I can't seem to find direction any which way you turn, be sure to reach out to the honest and goodness Microsoft project experts at EPMA. They'll swoop in and save your tail. Thank you.